So in this video, we're going to create a basic spend tracking tool to help you keep track of how much money is in your checking account at all times. And for me, a file like this also helps me know when my bills are coming due. So let's get started. Now we're gonna format this around when our pay period happens. So we're going to label the first column pay date. And I'm going to start with a date of a Friday because I get paid on Fridays, and I think most people do. If you don't get paid on Friday, then by all means, choose the date of your next pay date and just plug that in. So 11/4/2016, and for ease, let's assume we get paid every week. So we're going to do the date we plugged in plus 7, and we're just going to copy this down. You can do this for as many weeks and as you want to, just by copying down the rows. I'm only going to do a few here just to illustrate it. So then the next thing we want to do is amount paid. And we're just going to, an arbitrary number, let's say you get paid $2,000 a week. That's your take home. And so you're going to put that in for the first week. If you're salaried, you can put that all the way down. If it changes, then you would just do an estimate amount paid. I don't know, next week you're expecting $1,800 and then $2,100. You can do whatever you need. So that's how much we expect to get paid for the coming weeks. Then we also want to do a column that'll be the more important one where we'll see how much money we have on hand. So we'll type amount in checking account. And let's format these because they're all going to be headers, just so that they're a little bit easier to read our file. And you know what? We're going to put in here amount at beginning. And you'll only need this once. This is just going to be the amount that you had when you started to create this file. And for argument's sake, let's say there's $3,000 in your checking account. So on this first week, we're going to say we have $3,000 that was already there plus $2,000 that we got paid. So on 11/4, we have $5,000. Now, we need to pay our bills. So let's freeze these panes so we can separate everything. And then these are going to be where we list any additional payments going out of the account and deposits coming into the account. So let's say you have to pay your credit card bill, mortgage, or rent, I don't know, phone bill, and miscellaneous deposits. And obviously you can take this out to as many as you want to, do your own column titles with things that are easier for you to remember. But what I like to do, and this makes it easier for me also to know what's coming due. So we're going to get paid at 11/4. Then the next pay period happens 11/11. For me, I like to note the expense when it's going to happen. So let's say my credit card is due on 11/9. Well, that's after the 4th, before the 11th. I'm going to have to pay it on this cycle. So let's say that's $1,000. Oh, excuse me. We want to make this negative. So negative $1,000 because we're paying it out. And these guys should be dollars. Format those. 1,000. And then my rent is due at the end of the month. So let's say that's another 2,000. And we'll put that on the 11/25 date. The phone bill is due mid-month. So that'll be between 11/11 and 11/18. So that'll be 150. And let's say you make deposits. We all have deposits that we make. Someone gives you cash for something outside of when you got paid. You need to log that in. And so we, our miscellaneous deposit section is where we would do that. So let's say that, oh, lucky me, on the week after 11/18 and between and before 11/25, someone gave me $100. So this will be positive. Oh, and actually the phone bill will be negative, minus 150. So then what we want to do is just sum everything. So we have this first week, we have the $3,000 that we started, plus the $2,000 that we got paid, plus the sum of this row. So after we pay our credit card bill, we have $4,000. Now the next week is almost the same, except we need to take out cell B2, or that's going to screw us up later. So we'll delete that. We don't need it. That was only just for the first one. So this week we had, oh, and what we need to do is say the $4,000 from before. So we have $4,000 plus what we got paid minus what we took out. So here we had, we paid our credit card bill. There was $4,000 left. We added another $1,800, but we paid $150 for our phone bill. The end balance is $5,650. And now you can really just paste that down and you'll see how it adjusts. And let's say this is recurring. So this was November 25th. We need to pay our mortgage again around 12:30. So you can just plug that in again. And you can see here how every time you make a change, it alters that amount. So same thing, we know between 11, 4 and 11, 11, our credit card is due. So let's say it's going to be due again after 12 too. So let's say, oh, this is around Thanksgiving. So we spent more money. There was travel. So now we spent $2,000. And your formula will keep adjusting. And if you want, just to make it easier to see also, I would make this yellow so you know what's going on at any given time. And that is how you can keep track of your spend every week. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure to subscribe to this channel so you're the first to know on future videos. Thanks.